When I say on all these, in fact, on each one of these, the Supreme Court has clearly spoken. I wish to just start my opening statement with a quotation from the verdict itself. I quote, "In view of our findings on all the three aspects, and having heard the matter in detail, we find no reason for any intervention by this court on the sensitive issue of purchase of 36 defense aircrafts by the Indian government. Perception of individuals cannot be the basis of a fishing and roving inquiry by this court, especially in such matters. We thus dismiss all the writ petitions, leaving it to the parties to bear their own costs." Unquote. So, the Supreme Court, having gone through each one of these aspects which have been questioned, one, the decision-making process itself, two, the pricing, and on the offset partner, has clearly given reasons why they don't think the writ petition holds anymore. On the process, I would just like to say, clearly stating the process has been complied with, they've clearly mentioned that our country cannot afford to be unprepared, underprepared, in a situation where adversaries have acquired higher capabilities, emphasizing on the need for the purchase with a sense of urgency. They've of course said many more things. On the pricing, they've said despite the disinclination, despite their disinclination, the Supreme Court decided to comprehensively examine the case to satisfy its conscience, since acquisitions have been made in the open domain of huge escalations in costs. And notwithstanding the security agreement between the governments of India and France, which provides for protection of classified information, such as pricing details, these details too were made available to the Honorable Supreme Court in a sealed envelope. The Honorable Supreme Court has stated that we have, again quoting it, "We have examined closely the price details and comparison of the prices of the basic aircraft along with escalation costs as under the original RFP as well as under the IGA. We have also gone through the explanatory notes on the costing item-wise." This is unquote. So the court very clearly says they've gone through the cost item-wise and also compared it with the original RFP and the IGA. And finally, we say no more, again, they say, the court says, we say no more as the material has to be kept in a confidential domain. And finally, on the offsets, I'm only highlighting some of the portions from the verdict. Of course, Honorable FM will speak. You're also going to be asking us questions. I'm not taking more time on it. On the offsets, quote again, "We do not find any substantial material on record to show that this is a case of commercial favoritism to any party by the Indian government, as the option to choose the Indian offset partner does not rest with the Indian government." Further, the Honorable Supreme Court has mentioned, quote again, in this process, the role of the government is not envisaged, and thus mere press interviews or suggestions cannot form the basis for judicial review by this court, especially when there is a categorical denial of the statements made in the press by both the sides," unquote. So with this kind of a judgment, I think it's fairly clear where we need to be looking at now. The very important, one last very important observation which I draw your attention to is, quote again, "Adequate military strength and capability to discourage and withstand external aggression and to protect the sovereignty and integrity of India undoubtedly is a matter of utmost concern for the nation. The empowerment of defense forces with adequate technology and material support is therefore a matter of vital importance." unquote. So I would only want to highlight that on all the three heads on which concern was expressed in the writ, the court has come out clearly. The verdict is absolutely there for all of us to see. The matter on Rafael has thoroughly been, through the court, laid to rest. Thank you.